saints of God and good friends of Jesus Christ, very warm welcome to you all for this Sunday morning worship service, the fifth Sunday in the month of November. Today is also Advent Sunday, as they say, the beginning of the church year, as well as the beginning of the Christmas season. Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, our Heavenly Father, this is the day which the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. After being with us last night, Lord, and giving us your safety, security, and protection, you have granted us about this day to see your new blessings, your new compassions, your new graces. And we are here in this house of thine, Lord, to give thanks with a grateful heart, to glorify and magnify your great name through this worship service this morning, Lord God. Forgive us, Lord, for our sins and iniquities, and have mercy upon us. And may this worship service, O Lord God, particularly thy precious word from thy precious child, may it encourage us, Lord, to grow in grace and in the knowledge of Jesus Christ and of his precious word. Take all the glory during this time, Lord, for we pray in Jesus' precious name. Amen. Our opening hymn for this morning will be, O come, Emmanuel, and ransom of captive Israel. The opening hymn, O come, Emmanuel, and ransom of captive Israel.
Thank you.
we should follow the first order of service for our worship. Let us pray. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts be open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray together. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among men in whom he is well pleased. We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee, we give thanks to thee for thy great glory. O Lord God, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, takest away the sin of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sin of the world, receive our prayer. Thou that sittest at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy upon us. Thou only art holy, Thou only art Lord, Thou only art most high, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, glory of God. Amen. Brethren, we have come together to hear God's most holy word. Let us therefore kneel and examine ourselves in silence, seeking God's grace that we may draw near to Him with repentance and faith. Either do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins, and are in love and charity with your neighbors, and intend to live a new life following the commandments of God, and walking from henceforth in His holy ways, make your humble confession to Almighty God, that you may be reconciled anew to Him through our Lord Jesus Christ. Heavenly Father, we confess that we have sinned against Thee and our neighbor. We have walked in darkness rather than in light. We have named the name of Christ, but have not departed from iniquity. Have mercy upon us, we beseech Thee. For the sake of Jesus Christ, forgive us all our sins. Cleanse us by Thy Holy Spirit. Quicken our consciences. Enable us to forgive others, that we may henceforth serve Thee in newness of life, for the glory of Thy holy name. Hear the gracious word of God to all who truly turn to Him through Jesus Christ. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth on Him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And faithful is the saying, and worthy of all acceptation, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of His great mercy has promised forgiveness of sins to all who forgive their brethren, and with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto Him, have mercy upon us, pardon and deliver us from all our sins, confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and bring us to eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Thanks be to God. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. The collect of the day. The first Sunday in Advent. And the theme, joyful expectation of Christ's coming, together with meeting of Mary with Elizabeth. O God of all places and all times, in whose Son we find joy, hope, peace and salvation, help us to pray and long for the fullness of salvation, and grant us the grace to live the gladness of your salvation all through our lives, in order that you would find us blameless and holy in your presence when our Lord Jesus comes with all his holy ones, through Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Kindly be seated. So scripture portions will be read.
or man or inhabitant or beast. They shall be heard again. The voice of mourning and the voice of gladness, the voice of bridegroom and the voice of the bride, the voice of those who sing as they bring thank offering in the house of the Lord. Give thanks to the Lord of hosts, for the Lord is good, for his steadfast love endures forever. For I restore the fortunes of the land as at first, says the Lord. Thus says the Lord of hosts, in this place that is waste, without man or beast, and in all of the cities, there shall again be habitations of shepherds resting their flocks. In the cities of the hill country, in the cities of Shephthela, and in the cities of the Negev, in the land of Benjamin, the places of Jerusalem, and in the cities of Judah, flocks shall again pass under the hands of the one who counts them, says the Lord. The Lord's eternal covenant with David. Behold, the days are coming, declares the Lord, when I will fulfill the promise I made to the house of Israel and the house of Judah. In those days and at that time, I will cause a righteous branch to spring up for David, and he shall execute justice and righteousness in the land. In those days, Judah will be saved, and Jerusalem will dwell securely. And this is the name by which it will be called. The Lord is our righteousness.
Blessed are you among women, and blessed
and we see things. The announcements for this coming week. At the outset, I'd like to inform you that a pastor, Reverend Dr. Nyanamara, is away at Chennai. Today is the baptism service of his granddaughter. I am in Chennai. Disappointed you are unable to see him. You can meet him maybe tomorrow. Well, welcome to you all, dear friends of Jesus Christ, for the Sunday morning of worship service. The last Sunday of the month of November, as I say, Advent Sunday begins the new church calendar, and Christmas season also. Good Lord bless you all, and continue to worship with us. Our preacher this morning is the Reverend Dr. Vincent. Doesn't need much of an introduction, except that he is a legal luminary, I would say, a social activist also, and very much involved in other activities too. Anyway, you have a meeting with us, and good luck bless you as you bring us the Lord's Word. This evening service will be at 6 p.m. as usual, and on the first, Pastor decided to have the first of the month services once again, without, of course, the Eucharist. So on the first, that is Tuesday, we will have our usual service, God willing, at 6:30 a.m. Tuesday, the 1st of December, usual morning service at 6:30 a.m., without, of course, the Eucharist. And next Sunday, of course, services will be as usual, morning. 7:30 a.m. and evening at 6 p.m. No Eucharist for us. Let us pray for those who are unwell. Gracious God and Heavenly Father, any setback in our health, Lord God, even a very little minor one, Lord, involves a dislocation in life. Most so, Lord, when it is a mini major one also, Lord. It's a very difficult prospect to Lord to have a little dislocation from the routine of our life, Lord. Whatever it is, Lord, if these trials and troubles and tribulations and difficulties are just for the purpose of us growing in grace, in the knowledge of Jesus Christ, of His precious word, then Lord, we thank you that your grace is sufficient for us, for your strength is made perfect during our weakness, Lord God. So we accept, Lord God, whatever weakness there is, whatever setback there is, because we know and we thank you, Lord, that you are concerned about our situation, and you are concerned about kind of life that we lead also. Thank you so much, Lord. Continue to be with us, Lord, particularly these dear children who are in need of our prayers, Lord, but constantly, Lord, continuously, Lord. Take care of these dear children, Lord God. May you have mercy upon them also, Lord, and give them the good health and strength also, Lord. But we pray for those dear children, Lord God, not only as far as Tulna is concerned, not only as far as India is concerned, Lord, but the whole world, where the COVID-19 is creating havoc, Lord God. Many lakhs of people, Lord God, have been affected by it also. And many lakhs of people around the whole world have succumbed to this COVID-19, plunging the members of the family into despair, grief and sadness, Lord God. We pray, Lord, that in your time, when you make all things most beautiful, Lord God, you will give us the strength, Lord God, to adhere to the rules and regulations of the government, Lord, in order to keep ourselves safe, in order to keep our family members safe, Lord, in order to keep those whom we move around with safe also, Lord God. So bless us, Lord God, and bless keep a loving healing hand on them, O Lord. May they be revived and healed in such a way, Lord, that they will give thanks to you with a grateful heart, and you will glorify your great name, because we pray in Jesus' precious name. Birthdays and wedding anniversaries for this week, from the 30th to the 5th of November. And the 1st of December is the birthday of Mr. Jayashresh Jayaraj, Dr. S. Arjun Paul, Mr. John Franklin, Master Rowan Bimal Victor, Mr. Emmanuel Samson John, and Miss Evangelina. And the 2nd is the birthday of Mr. Judson Ezekiel. On the 4th, Dr. Praveen Sandeep Raj. And on the 5th, Mr. Jensen Jeevaraj Yuji. God bless these dear children who are celebrating their birthdays, their wedding anniversaries, and may He add His very special blessings on their special day. Let us pray for them. God bless you on your birthday. God bless you and sustain you with each new dawning day. God grant you grace and wisdom to travel life's highway. God give you strength and courage when things perplex your mind. God help you reach your cherished goal you seek and strive to find. God comfort you when in distress and trouble come your way. God be with you and watch over you. We humbly ask and pray. Announcing the good news, we are pleased to announce the birth of a baby boy for Mrs. Nitya Vinod Daniel and Mr. Vinod Daniel on the 26th at Madurai. Congratulations to the parents and grandparents, and pray the good Lord would bless them. Bands of marriage. I published the bands of marriage between Ms. G. Damaris Jayamani, daughter of Mrs. Mercy J. Silly, member of our church, and Mr. D. David Barnabas, son of Mrs. D. Vatsala Lydia, member of CSR, Living Shepherd Church, Anandagar, Chennai. If any of you know any just cause why these two persons should not be joined together in holy matrimony, you ought to declare it in writing to the PC chairperson of this pastorate. This is the 2nd time of asking. Let us pray. Gracious God, our Heavenly Father, having known that Adam desired and helped me for him, Lord, you created Eve to be his helpmate, Lord, thereby instituting matrimony, the sacrament of marriage for God. And from then on we see, Lord, a number of marriages have been solemnized, bringing both man and woman together to form a family, which is very, very vital, crucial in your sight, O Lord. Because we know that you sent your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, to be born in a family, thus exalting the family, Lord God, to the extent to which it has been created by you, the Holy Family. May we all continue to be holy families also, Lord God, to bring glory to your great name as we continue to support one another in our family life, Lord. And these two children who will be joined together in matrimony, Lord, Damaris and David, we ask your blessings upon them. as they prepare for this holy institution of marriage. Yet they also know and prepare themselves to understand the serious consequences of marriage to Lord God, and to avoid it by your scripture, where the blueprint is already there for a happy married life with God. Pray your blessings upon the preparations, the parents, so that everything will be done with the glory and honor of your great and wonderful name. We pray in Jesus' precious name. We will now have a message, a sermon by Reverend Dr. Vincent.
We worship you, thank you, Lord. You have brought us here in this church as brothers and sisters on this very precious day, the Holy Sunday. Also, this is a day that the liturgical year begins, Lord, that is your grace. When we gather here, fill us with your Holy Spirit. The words of my mouth, now the reflections and the meditations of all our heart, be acceptable in your sight, O Lord. Amen. Brothers and sisters, first I thank God for having given me this opportunity to preach one more time in this church. I need to thank Pastor and the Pastor Committee and also all of you for having given me this opportunity. As it was already announced and said by our Pastor, as we are all aware, today is the last Sunday of this month. At the same time, today is the first day of the Advent season, which means the liturgical year starts from today. That's why our CSI has given a wonderful theme as the joyful expectation of Christ's coming. But one more day, one more importance is also on this day, which you have seen in the CSI almanac. And today is the day of the formation of CMI, Church of North India. Church of South India was formed in on 27th of September. I was the preacher of this in this church on the day as well. Before going into the theme for today, we need to think a little bit about this CMI. Because the whole world, only in India, the four important streams of churches will come together in CSI and CMI. Nowhere else. The Anglican, the Methodist, the Presbyterian, and the Baptist. All these four streams have come together in CSI in 1947. But it took long years for the formation of CMI in North India. As we are aware, CSI has got 24 dioceses. We are having 24 dioceses. But in the North India, in those days, there were included some dioceses from Pakistan and also in Bangladesh. And even today they are there. And Nepal is also having one dioceses. Therefore, they are having 27 dioceses. And 22 lakhs of members are there. And if you go to the website, you will find that they are having more than 565 schools and colleges they run, and 65 hospitals as a mission they are taking. the rest of the things we are all aware, and we have to really thank God for having brought all these things to come under one single identity as CMI. But they are not able to celebrate this because of this corona period. You know that I am always in Delhi, I have an office there. I have a close contact with the CMI people, but they are all very much upset because they are not able to celebrate this day at 1972. Anyway, this is we have to remember that we have to thank God for this. Moving on to today's theme, the joyful expectation of Christ coming. Christ coming is an expectation for all of us because Christ is known as Messiah. I turned the pages of many books and found which are the religions, because we are all aware, that there are 13 major religions in this world, and Christianity may be the very largest one. So, three religions are having this concept of Messiah. As we are all aware, this is Judaism. Even Jews, even today, they are saying the Messiah will be coming. For them, Christ is not a Messiah, as we are all aware. And Christianity, definitely, we believe in this concept of Messiah, the Redeemer. Jesus is the Messiah for us, the Christ. And the one more is Zoroastrianism. They say Zoroastrianism is also having the same concept of Messiah. And some are saying Taoism is also having, but some are saying it's not like that. When you read the Quran and the Muslim scholars, they say, we believe in that, but we see Messiah in the form of Christ, that is Jesus. I'm not very much sure of the Muslim scholars' statement on that, but they say, Messiah we believe, but there is only Jesus, because he was the last prophet who came. But second coming we don't accept. This is what they say. Second coming there is more. So, in short, the Messiah concept is originally, the Messiah concept has come from the Judaism. Because even today, the Jewish people, the Judaism people are expecting their Messiah to come. Why Messiah is coming? Because we are all in sin. And definitely Messiah will come and save us. To give salvation to us. For our eternal life. Because this life, worldly life is only temporary for all of us. That we believe also. So what they say is that when the Messiah comes, the salvation will come from the dead. And the eschatologically, what we believe is eschatological, what we mean is that it's kind of a theological quotation, what they say is the end times. Jesus will come on the second coming, that is our belief, our faith. But Judaism people are saying that no, Jesus is not the Messiah, the Messiah will come. He will come in the dynasty of King David. And he will take us to the eternal life, the heaven. This is their faith. But we believe that Christ is the Messiah. That is why today's theme is very beautifully calling us the joyful expectation of Christ. Definitely it will be joyful, we are all aware of that. Because when Messiah comes, we get the salvation and we will have an eternal life. This is very easy for all of us to understand. But whether that is the only aspect for which we need to be joyful, or is there any other aspect also to make us be more joyful? That is where we have to look into the Old Testament reading of today, and the Ephesians reading, and also finally the Gospel reading. I am not going to read the whole thing, but the substance only we will get there. As you are all aware, when we give all these three texts, there is a connectivity to the theme. So, where is the joy? What is the type of joy that we could have in the Old Testament days, or immediately after the death of Jesus, the resurrection of Jesus, what happened in the first century, that we have to see, and there is a connectivity to that. And finally, the gospel in the Luke Gospel 39 chapter, what we are seeing that Mother Mary and the Elizabeth things. So in the Old Testament reading, as we already listened to that, what it says is that people are saying this Judea and Israel are the two provinces, and also Jerusalem city is the holy city. This is like a desert now. When Jeremiah prophesied, it was a desert. Because it was ruled by, at that point of time, it was ruled by King Nebuchadnezzar of Babylon. He came, conquered, and took all the people as captives, and even he destroyed the whole Judea and Jerusalem. That is where, when Jeremiah sees that, he is saying, people are saying, this is a desert. People cannot live here. Even animals cannot live here. The street of Jerusalem is always for feasts and celebrations and all for the joyful things, but it is not happening here. This is the present state of affairs. But this reading part says that Jeremiah is saying, a king will come, a king will come. That will, the king will change the whole thing into a different kind of situation. That's what I will say. He will rule with righteousness and justice. He will do what is right and what is just. And he will rule over. So again, you will get the same glory. When the king comes, the desert will be a prosperous land. Again, you will get all your earlier prosperous things you will gain. This is what they are saying. So this is a connectivity for us to also reflect. In our life, salvation is one, because it's for everyone. But in our life, in case we are having the same kind of desertness, or same kind of any bondage, or same kind of anything which makes us to be of, in a very bad state of affairs, when Jesus comes, that is when Jesus comes, Christ when he comes, this will be changed. Again, you will get the same glory. So you must have a belief on it. You must have a faith on it. This is what the first reading of the Old Testament reminds us. Salvation, yes. Because in this reading it is saying, it's a day of salvation. It's saying. So salvation is also there. And also the world in life, whatever you face, the hardship, that will be over and you will get the original glory. So this is what in the Old Testament. When we move on to the epistle, that is the Paul's letter to the people. And what he's saying is that there also he's saying there was persecution already. The persecution is there in the area. And the history goes like this. If you read it, what he says is that Saint Paul was already there in Thessalonica. And he was preaching. And the Jewish people, who are already in the Judaism people, some have started following Christianity. More than that, the Gentiles, they were also there. And they listened to St. Paul, and they become Christians. This was very much opposed by the Judaism people, the Jewish people. That's why even Paul was not able to remain there. He moved and he was staying in another place, not in Thessalonica. But his mind was on this people. I preached there. I have baptized some people. They have become Christians. Now for various reasons I have come back. But these people should be strengthened. So he sent his companion Timothy. That is why if you go and read at your home, your homes will find out. Timothy has gone there, met the people, he has come back and reported to St. Paul saying that they are practicing Christianity. They believe in Christ, And also they are saying that they are keeping their faith. They are loving God and also loving man. And they are fellow human beings. This is the very important thing. Even there is a persecution, definitely you have to remain in faith. You have to love God and love the neighbor. This is the crux of Christianity always. So both are there. That is why if you read that epistle, Thessalonians 3:6-13, when you read, you will find out definitely Paul is writing to his people again saying that I am very much happy that you are in that persecution, but still you maintain your faith. And you love God and also love others, one another, as he said. So you will be definitely blessed. So the same thing today, we have to reflect and meditate within ourselves. If we are in persecution, I do not want to say what type of persecution that we are facing today as a community, especially as a Christian community. Even in our own homes as individuals, as a family, community, society, our nation, we are under severe persecution for various reasons. But we have to remain in faith. We have to love God with a strong hope. Lord, you will come. It's a joyful coming for me. And you will save this nation, this society, this community, this family, me, all that we have. Because I will remain in faith, number one. And also, I will love you, God. And also, I will love all others. This is very, very important that we have to take it from this. This is true. Moving on to the gospel. Very interesting. I listened to our pastor's message. He uploaded in the YouTube. Some of you have already read it. Pastor was also our pastor. Today, this morning, was saying the joyful coming of Christ is one expectation. Joyful expectation of Christ coming. The other one is Mother Mary needs Elizabeth. That is the portion that we have already read. And we are always saying that what are the things that happened when Mother Mary and Elizabeth met? What are the things that happened on the day? But normally what the people will say, definitely, we have to take that from Galilee, Mother Mary has gone to Judea. Galilee is in the north, they say. And Judea is in the south, as we are aware. And Judea is only Jerusalem is there. Galilee is only blind part. Judea is a second country. That's why they are saying that the blind country, Mother Mary has gone to the country. So how they are trying to come together. That's the way they are reflecting in their always. The other one is she was very young. Mother Mary was so young and Elizabeth was old. So the young and the old event. Then the one more thing is what they say is that Elizabeth, Mother Mary is a very ordinary woman. But if you read the text, it is saying, he hails from the King David's dynasty, it is saying. But she is very poor. She is not like Zachariah's wife, Elizabeth. Zachariah is a priestly person. He comes from the dynasty of Abijah. And the theologians say, it is not in the Bible, in the Old Testament, they say, that Elizabeth hails from the Aaron's, whatever it is, his dynasty. So it's a priestly class. But this lady is not from the priestly class. Who? Mother Mary. So they met. So the ordinary lay people are meeting the priestly class. These are the things they will say. And many others also, they say she is very poor. And Zachariah also has little middle class person. All these kinds of things they will say. But very importantly, we have to remind one or two things more to this context. One is that both of them, their pregnancy was announced by angel. Angel met both Joseph and also Mary. But in the case of Elizabeth, the angel met and announced the birth of John the Baptist only to the daughter, not to Elizabeth. But anyway, both Christ and Jesus' birth and the John's birth were announced by the angel. In that way, it's a kind of a similarity. That's something that there are. So when the people say, they will say, when the preachers are saying, when Mother Mary Elizabeth reads, what happens is that the high and low, the rich and poor, these things are now coming down as they are meeting, even before the birth of John the Baptist and also Christ, Jesus. That this unification takes place. Otherwise, it will be always a divided, a kind of discriminated, a despised, and also those who are in the purity, impurity classes are included. So these all will go when Jesus is born. This indicates, our pastor was always saying in his prayers, the indicators should go. Even this morning, when before the church, he was praying with the yesterday saying the indicators should go, and there must be consoling and comforting. Very quickly, I thought when we prayed inside, I thought this is the thing that we are expected to happen, because when Jesus comes, indicators will go. That is the kind of thing that when Elizabeth and Mother Mary went there, she is taking the lead. Christ is taking the lead, by the way, to bring everything to order, everything to be saved. So this also is that's what happened. One more very, very important thing is, both John the Baptist and Jesus, they were killed. It was very good that they were announced, their births were announced. But it's not for a very prosperous life. To save others, you have to do it. One was beheaded, the other one was crucified. See, here it's not easy to think how much these two women, Mother Mary and Elizabeth, would have gone through a kind of failing in their heart. But there is no mentioning about whether Elizabeth was there when John the Baptist was there. But when Jesus was crucified, Mother Mary was there. So it's very difficult for a mother to do something like this, even for Zachary and Elizabeth, whether they were born, they were living or not. They face this. How much? When we read this, when we listen like this, we are happy. Okay, Jesus is coming. The communities will go. Inequalities will go. Everything will be saved. It is easy to hear. And how much we act, we may be lowly. Whether we make any effort to go and join hands with the rich or with the people who are in dominance. Maybe in ethnicity, maybe in caste, maybe in race, maybe in our economic affluence. It's very good. Even when we go there, whether there will be any reception. But this is possible only in Christ. Because Christ gave us a gift. We read in the Welcome, Welcome in the Morning, that song, in which it is saying, very correctly it is saying that when you are coming, you have come as a kind of a ransom. If we know that it is a ransom. Ransom is the meaning of giving your life. Are we prepared to give our life? Are we prepared to grow our children? With a sense of sacrifice, with a sense of risking their lives for the betterment of the entire family, for the entire world. But we cannot say that it is God's plan only, the angel only announced, and in our family it is not happening. No. Even your childhood is God's plan. And we have to see that how much we are also taking efforts like Mother Mary and Elizabeth to come together, and also how much we are making our sons and daughters to come together to face the real sins in this country and be involved in some kind of action by which we are making this world to be a very deserved world to receive Christ. So this is a very important thing that we are getting today, and that is why we say today the expectation is very joyful. When we go home, we have to take this message with us. Say, laugh. I am joyful today because you have come to save me, and also for making me to be a person to establish peace just right in this world. So therefore I am glad. More than an actual part of the Indian situation, we are only 2.8 in which the Roman Catholic Church alone 90 million were blind to live in. This is a established statistics, even it has come from later. So we are the Protestant Church people, as the statistics say, we have 11 million people. In a way, we are blessed because we have a faith that we are Christians, we believe in Jesus, we believe in Christ, we believe in salvation. People who live in this world as a kind of people who got the salvation. So let the Holy Spirit bless us. Let's pray. Loving God, you have given time for us today to reflect. You have given time. You have promised Jesus, but you died and resurrected as Christ. We are happy over you, Lord, in this world, especially in this part of our world. We are Christians who believe that you are the Messiah. You made us to be worthy of worshipping the Messiah and also to make ourselves and our family members to carry forward the same kind of presence, the sacrifices that you placed in the in this world. Energize us and strengthen us. Bless us. We ask in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
We shall all stand and affirm our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. The Nicene Creed: I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, dedicated PC members and the pastors are taking special care and attention to ensure the Christmas service, the New Year service, and other allied activities. We also call upon to pray for good health for our bishop and all of the pastors in our diocese. We pray for all the congregation all over our diocese during this Christmas and the New Year season. We also pray for our own church members as they regularly attend the church services Sunday morning and Sunday evening. And the good Lord will continue to keep us all safe and free from all harm and danger and evil, but most particularly from any effects of the COVID-19. Let us pray the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. O Lord, our Heavenly Father, Almighty and Everlasting God, who has safely brought us to the beginning of this day, defend us in the same with thy mighty power, and grant that this day we fall into no sin, neither run into any kind of danger, but that all our doings may be ordered by thy governance, to do always that is righteous in thy sight, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Almighty Lord and Everlasting God, vouchsafe we beseech thee to direct, sanctify, and govern both our hearts and bodies in the ways of thy laws, and in the works of thy commandments, that through thy most mighty protection, both here and ever, we may be preserved in body and soul through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Under God's gracious mercy and protection, we come unto you. The Lord bless us and the Lord keep us. The Lord make his face to shine upon us and the Lord be gracious unto us. The Lord lift up his countenance upon us and the Lord give us peace. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep our hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst us and remain with us always. Thank you.